to Facebook. So we will start very shortly. I'm not sure it's going to Facebook.
VA Council of Churches, Sandy?
It should be. Yes, it doesn't look like it's.
All right.
It was telling me invalid parameters, and I don't know what that means, but it's not going there.
Put in the codes completely in the password?
I'm sorry?
You put in the codes and the password?
I did. So okay. I'm not sure what happened here. I'm going to take a second and look this up. So we're going to be a couple of minutes late starting. I apologize to you. Oh, it looks like it is, should be there. Okay, we should be going live in just a couple of moments, finally. I apologize for that. Good evening, sisters and brothers. I am pleased and honored to welcome you to our first ever service in observance of Women's History Month. I'm Reverend Sandy Strauss, Director of Advocacy and Ecumenical Outreach for the Pennsylvania Council of Churches. And the Council of Churches is a fellowship of Christian denominations working together for unity for the sake of the world. We're joined this evening by a diverse group of women from across Pennsylvania representing a number of different denominations. We come together not just to celebrate our diversity, but the role and contributions of women through the years. Thank you for joining us this evening. And now I would like to introduce Representative Patty Kim. She represents the 103rd District here in Harrisburg, and I'm pleased and proud to say that she is my representative. So, Patty, would you like to speak?
Sure. Thank you, Reverend Strauss. Thank you for organizing this special event. It's so good to be a part of this program, honoring women and being in the midst of very strong women this evening. My dad recalled this story about my grandmother. Before the Korean War started, she and her five young children had to leave China and return to South Korea by foot. It was a dangerous journey. Soldiers on horseback were known to stop travelers and take them away, or worse. One evening, as they were walking in a large group with other families, they heard horses coming towards them in the dark. Many in that group quickly ran down a steep hill to hide in a ditch to avoid the military men. My grandmother was traveling without my grandfather, and she didn't have time to help all of her small children down to safety. She also knew if her baby started to cry, it would draw attention to the group's hiding spot. So with her children trembling behind her legs, she decided to stay on the path and stand as the soldiers on horseback approached them. With all of her might, she declared, "Take me, but leave my children alone." The two soldiers, shocked by her bravery and boldness, backed off and decided to let her go. My father was only 8 then, but remembers that moment very clearly. I come from my grandmother. I have her strength and faith in God. It empowers me to remember who she was, and I'm grateful for her courage and wisdom. That's what I believe Women's History Month is all about. We remember the women who helped pave the way, and we remind ourselves of the strength we carry as well. I hope you will find comfort and inspiration tonight, and let's do what my grandmother did, shock others with our bravery, and do what's best for our children and the community. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
A call to worship from the book of Proverbs. Wisdom has built herself a house. She has prepared her food, mixed her wine, and set her table. She calls to all in the cities and in the town, "Come and eat my food and drink the wine I have made." You are wisdom.
You are wisdom, holy wisdom, wisdom. Holy wisdom, wisdom you are.
Who can find a valiant woman? She is far more precious than jewels. Give her a share in what her hands have made. Let her works tell her praises.
You are wisdom, holy wisdom, holy wisdom you are.
Wisdom calls aloud in the streets. I will pour out my heart to you. Tune your ear to wisdom and your heart to truth. Then you will understand who God is and discover love of life. Then you will understand justice and the ways of happiness.
You are wisdom, holy wisdom. Holy wisdom you are.
Wisdom is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs at the days to come. Many are the women of proven worth, but you have excelled them all.
You are wisdom. 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 Holy wisdom. Wisdom. You are.
It's no grave. Amen, amen, and amen. And now a prayer for the women through the ages. Let us pray. Spirit of renewal, God of many names, and one transforming and abundant love, we turn this month in our nation's life to reflect on the stories, the heritage, and the struggles of the women throughout the ages. We seek to learn from all those voices that have been left unheard. May we pause before the silences of the ages, find who has been left out, and craft new ways of inclusion for every week and every month. May this spiritual practice bring out the voices of all those struggling, all those left apart. May we let go of our assumptions and cold comforts of what is the normal to live by, unless it be a standard that is rooted in compassion, in inclusivity, in diversity. May this month of reflection teach us to search for those stories that are different from our own. Mother of possibility, in the finding, may we come to know ourselves changed, renewed where we are dry, hopeful where we are lost, and open where we are shut.
Friends, let us come before God, opening ourselves, sharing our imperfections, our sins, our brokenness, that God might turn and make us whole. Let us pray. Loving and merciful God, you created each of us in your own image to live in community. You graced us generously with the gifts of apostles, prophets, pastors, and teachers. You equipped all of us, women and men alike, for the work of ministry. Yet too often we tarnish your image, waste our gifts, refuse to accept your call to service, and fail to live at peace with our neighbors. O God, in the name of Christ, help us to turn to you to shape us as you intended when you created us. Fill us with your Spirit and strengthen us to continue our journey and complete the task of shaping the Christian community as one people of God. We trust that all things are possible through you. In the name of Christ, amen.
Hear these words of good news. Beloved in Christ, you are blessed by God to inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you are refashioned every day to live according to God's reign in the freedom of Christ Jesus. Friends, know that you are forgiven and be at peace.
This is a song for every girl who's ever been through something she thought she couldn't make it through, yeah. I sing these words because I was that girl too, wanting something better than this, but who do I turn to? Now we're moving from the darkness into the light, yeah. This is the defining moment of our lives. Cause you're beautiful like a flower, more valuable than a diamond. You are powerful like a fire, you will heal the world with your mind, and there is nothing in the world that you cannot do when you believe in you, who are beautiful, yeah, you, who are brilliant, yeah, you, who are powerful, yeah, you, who are resilient. This is a song for every girl who's ever been through something that she thought she couldn't make it through. Girl, you can make it through. I sing these words because I know you're the one who knows there's something better than this, and you're gonna define it, yeah. Now we're moving from the darkness into the light, yeah. This is the defining moment of our lives. Cause you're beautiful like a flower, more valuable than a diamond. You are powerful like a fire, you will heal the world with your mind, and there is nothing in the world that you cannot do when you believe in you, who are beautiful, yeah, you, who are brilliant, yeah, you, who are powerful, yeah, you, who are resilient, yeah, you, who are beautiful, yeah, you, who are brilliant, yeah, you, who are powerful, yeah, you, who are resilient, yeah, you, oh, yeah, you, hey, yeah, you, yeah, you, oh, yeah, you, yeah, you.
Hear the word of God in Holy Scripture. This reading is from the 15th chapter of Exodus, beginning at the 19th verse. When the horses of Pharaoh with his chariots and his chariot drivers went into the sea, the Lord brought back the waters of the sea upon them,
But the Israelites walked through the sea on dry ground. Then the prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women went out after her with tambourines and with dancing. And Miriam sang to them, "Sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Amen. God's word coming out of Esther, chapter 4, verses 8 to 14, reads like this. Mordecai also gave him a copy of the written decree issued in Susa for their destruction, that he might show it to Esther, explain it to her, and charge her to go to the king to make supplication to him and entreat him for her people. Hathach went and told Esther what Mordecai had said. Then Esther spoke to Hathach and gave him a message for Mordecai, saying, "All the king's servants and the people of the king's provinces know that if any man or woman goes to the king inside the inner court without being called, there is but one law. All alike are to be put to death. Only if the king holds out the golden scepter to someone, may that person live. I myself have not been called to come into the king for 30 days. When they told Mordecai what Esther had said, Mordecai told them to reply to Esther, "Do not think that in the king's palace you will escape any more than all the other Jews. For if you keep silence at such a time as this, relief and deliverance will rise from the Jews from another quarter, but you and your father's family will perish. Who knows? Perhaps you have come to royal dignity for just such a time as this."
Hear the word of the Lord from Acts chapter 16, verses 9 to 15. During the night, Paul had a vision. There stood a man of Macedonia pleading with him and saying, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." When he had seen the vision, we immediately tried to cross over to Macedonia, being convinced that God had called us to proclaim the good news to them. We set sail from Troas and took a straight course to Samothrace, and following day to Neapolis, and from there to Philippi, which is a leading city in the district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We remained in this city for some days. On the Sabbath day, we went outside the gate by the river, where we supposed there was a place of prayer. And we sat down and spoke to the women who had gathered there. A certain woman named Lydia, a worshiper of God, was listening to us, and she was from the city of Thyatira and a dealer in purple cloth. The Lord opened her heart to listen eagerly to what was said by Paul. When she and her household were baptized, she urged us, saying, "If you have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come and stay at my home." And she prevailed upon us. This is the word of the Lord. Amen.
Thanks be to God.
My friends, I am the Reverend Dr. Bonnie Bates. I have come to be with you to share a word this day. I hope that in fact it is a word that comforts you. I serve as the conference minister for the Penn Northeast Conference of the United Church of Christ, and greet you on behalf of our 130 churches. I'm really pleased to offer this reflection on this occasion. Pennsylvania Council of Churches, First Women's History Month and International Women's Day service. As a woman in ministry, these scriptures that were read this evening speak to me and reflect at least a portion of the women's experience. consider a little history with me. The actual celebration of Women's History Month grew out of a week-long celebration of women's contributions to culture, history, and society, organized by the School District of Sonoma, California in 1978. A few years later, the idea had caught on within communities and school districts and organizations across the country. In 1980, President Jimmy Carter issued the first presidential proclamation declaring the week of March 8th as National Women's History Week. The U.S. Congress followed suit the next year, passing a resolution establishing a national celebration. 6 years later, the National Women's History Project successfully petitioned Congress to expand the event to the entire month of March. The United Nations has sponsored International Women's Day since 1975, when adopting its resolution on the observance of International Women's Day, the United Nations General Assembly cited the following reasons. To recognize the fact that securing peace and social progress and the full employment of human rights and fundamental freedoms require the active participation, equality, and development of women. In so much of Scripture, the women are unnamed. We know some of the names and we celebrate some of them this evening, but we do not know, for instance, the name of the woman at the well, or the woman who confronts Jesus that even dogs get the scraps from the table, or the woman healed of the issue of blood, or the woman healed in the temple on Sabbath so that she might stand straight. How many other women in our scripture, in our lives, and in our cultures are unnamed, unrecognized, and unappreciated? Countless, I'm sure. I could not name them all here, but the scriptures I chose talk about and demonstrate some of the characteristics of women I want us to focus on this evening. Let's begin with the Esther passage. Esther was a woman of her culture. She was orphaned as a child, and her cousin Mordecai adopted her and brought her up. When Queen Vashti fell into disgrace because of her disobedience to the king, Esther was among the beautiful virgins chosen to be presented to the king. The king was struck by her beauty and made her queen instead of Vashti. Esther, however, did not reveal the fact that she was a Jew. And when the king ordered the destruction of all the Jews, Mordecai sought Esther's intervention. Esther originally refused, citing the practice of the king to kill anyone who came into the inner court without being called. One might say that decision was the logical one, the one that would protect her. Mordecai pushes a little and assures Esther that she will not escape the fate of her people. And perhaps Mordecai relates, "You have come to royal dignity for such a time as this." Esther, risking her own life, does in fact speak to the king. She does in fact save her people. She does act in the unexpected manner with a courage that might have been unexpected in her time and especially for her gender. Esther steps out in faith. She acts with courage and she changes the course of history. How many other women in our history, in our communities, and in our personal lives have done the same? Likely there are some we have heard about, maybe even read about. Yet how many have not been named or recognized? This month is a time to stretch our experience and our minds and to learn about the unnamed and under-recognized women of our history. This month is also a time to act with courage, to speak out for the rights, safety, education, and recognition of the differences women make in the world. I think we have a lot to learn about women, even as women. The story of Lydia in Acts has always been one of my favorites, although it's very brief. In fact, when asked during an interview by a pastoral search committee who my favorite biblical character was, except for Jesus, of course, I named Lydia. Let's think about her for a moment. Lydia was already proclaimed to be a woman of faith, but she was also a woman of business and a head of household. In a patriarchal culture where women weren't often the owners of anything, she had created a business selling purple cloth, a cloth primarily used by royalty and the elite. She likely had worked very hard and very well to build a business as a woman in a culture that all but denied her existence for anything but marriage and childbearing. Lydia was a strong, capable, and unafraid woman, wise in the way of business and successful. She was a woman who believed in God, but who also believed in herself. She had not let the cultural expectations and norms of her society govern her life. She had stepped outside the norm and become successful in her faith, in her work, and in her home. Lydia invites Paul to her home to teach, and more importantly, to baptize her whole household. How many women do you know, do you remember, do you think of fondly who have done the non-traditional thing, who have stood up against the odds and made a difference, succeeded beyond expectation? Had the strength of character and wisdom, ambition and insight to use their gifts for the benefits of themselves and their families. This month is a time to act with strength of character, wisdom, ambition, and insight. To speak out for the rights, equity in the workplace, access for women to express their business acumen. I think we have a lot to learn about women, even as women. Now back to the Exodus passage. Miriam is the sister of Aaron and Moses, by the way, the older sister. And as the oldest sister in a family of four children, I know the responsibilities that fell to me, to watch out for the young ones, to assure they were supervised and cared for when my parents weren't available, to follow the rules, to be the good example for others. It was heady to be the boss sometimes, but the responsibility was a little overwhelming. Miriam is named a prophet, one who is named by the Talmud as one of the seven major female prophets of Israel. And according to the Midrash, just as Moses led the men out of Egypt and taught them the Torah, so Miriam led the women and taught them the Torah. Miriam is honored by those in the Jewish faith as partnering with Moses and Aaron to bring God's people out of slavery. In this reading from Exodus, the Israelites have escaped from Pharaoh's chariots and soldiers through the miracle of the parting and the bringing back of the waters of the Red Sea. And who leads the praise and celebration? Miriam, who takes the tambourine in hand and leads the women to dance and sing to the Lord. She leads the praise and worship of God. She takes it upon herself to be the celebrant of the worship. There is wisdom here for us as well. As a minister of the United Church of Christ, I'm honored to serve in a denomination that has many firsts, one of which is the ordination of the first woman in a mainline Protestant denomination, Antoinette Brown. Moreover, she was ordained in the predecessor church to the one in which I was ordained. She was ordained in 1853. I, as the second woman to be ordained from that church, wasn't ordained until 2005. Now that might say something about the resistance to women as worship leaders and ordained ministers. It might just be that particular church, but I hear many stories of many strong women of faith who are told to seek another profession other than ordained ministry as late as the 1980s. And some denominations still will not ordain women or even allow them to hold leadership positions in church. Certainly, Miriam and Antoinette demonstrate effective preaching and teaching in the church and in the community. Yet the point of sharing Miriam's story is to talk about the celebratory nature of her worship. This was her gift as preacher, teacher, prophet, and worship leader. She knew how to praise God. She knew how to gather people unto her and share the joy of faith with them. This is a strength we can all use in these challenging days. How many women do you know who live their faith, their lives, with joy and hope, with the celebrations of the moments of God's presence? This is a month to remember the women who bring praise and joy into the world, whose character and faith doesn't fit in a box or in some preordained design. I think we have a lot to learn about women, even as women. So my friends, let us learn from these women. Let us learn to move into the wholeness of our own lives with courage, accenting our abilities, celebrating our successes and our personal power, our wisdom and insight, our ambition, and ability to stand for what is right and just and fair in the world. Perhaps if we can each and all do that, women's roles, contributions, and success will become so integrated into the fabric of our lives and our history that we will not limit our celebration of women and their gifts to just the month of March.
This prayer is called the Women's Creed. We believe in God who creates women and men as partners in God's image, to work together in harmony, respecting and honoring each other. We believe that we are co-workers with God in creating and preserving life. We believe in God who took human form to redeem us from fear and prejudice, anger and hatred, greed and selfishness. We believe in Jesus who empowered women and outcasts and gives them new life. We believe in the Spirit active in our world, who encourages and nurtures, strengthens and restores us. We believe in the Spirit who quickens us to be involved in the work of the reign of God.
You may write me down in history.
You may write me down in history.
With your bitter, twisted lies.
With your bitter, twisted lies.
You may trod me.
You may trod me.
In the very dirt.
In the very dirt.
But still like dust.
But still
does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom?
Why are you beset with gloom?
Cause I walk like I've got all wells. I'm thinking by living wrong.
Just like moon.
Just like moon. like suns.
And like suns.
With a certainty.
With a certainty.
Of time.
Just like
just
hope.
Just like hope.
Springing high. Did you want to see me broken?
Did you want to see me broken?
Bowed head and lowered eyes.
Shoulders falling down like teardrops. Wakened
by my soulful cry.
Does my heart keep this a feel? Don't you take it awful hard.
Don't take it awful hard. You may shoot me with your words.
You may
cut me with your eyes.
You
may kill me with your hatefulness. But still, like life, I'll rise.
Does my sexiness substantial? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamond at the meeting of my mind?
I rise.
Out of the huts of history's shame.
I rise.
Up from a past that's rooted in pain.
That my ancestors gave.
I
am the hope and the dream of the slave.
Still I rise.
I rise.
I rise. Just like moons.
I rise.
Like sun.
I rise.
Still I rise.
I rise.
I rise.
We speak your names. Because we are free women, born of free women, who are born of free women, as back as far as time begins, we celebrate your freedom. Because we are wise women, born of wise women, who are born of wise women, we celebrate your wisdom. Because we are strong women, born of strong women, who are born of strong women, we celebrate your strength. Because we are magical women, born of magical women, who are born of magical women, we celebrate your magic.
My sisters, we are gathered here to speak your name. We are here because we are your daughters, as surely as if you had conceived us, nurtured us, carried us in your womb, and then sent us out into the world to make our mark and see what we see and be what we be, but better, truer, deeper, because of the shining example of your own incandescent light.
We are here because you taught us that. Sister Speak can continue to be our native tongue, no matter how many languages we learn, as we move about as citizens of the world and as ever evolving universe. We are here to speak your names because of the way you made the way you made for us, because of the prayers you prayed for us.
We are the ones you conjured up, hoping we would have strength enough and discipline enough and talent enough and nerve enough to step into the light. When it turned in our direction and just smile a while.
We are the ones you hoped would make you proud, because all of our hard work makes all of yours part of something better, truer, deeper. Something that lights the way ahead like a lamp unto our feet, as steady as the unforgettable beat of our collective heart.
We speak your names. We speak your names. We speak your names.
Prayers of the people. Faithful God, we thank you that we are known by you, and you have called us to go into the world to do your work.
Lead us, we pray.
You called us to love and to be loved as we do justice in your field.
Help us, we pray.
We come in humility, asking that you will give us courage and wisdom to become ambassadors of your peace and reconciliation.
Hear us, we pray.
You made us like you and called us to be unique. As you look at us, you see the same people you created in your image.
Help us, we pray.
Help us, Lord, that we may be able to stand up against any injustice.
Hear us, we pray. We are glad to be your people as we all come together with one voice, answering and making a commitment that will not be kept quiet if there is injustice, but we will stand up and do your work of love, peace, and reconciliation. As you have called us to be one, we recommit ourselves to this calling. We pray all this through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
A litany of sending. In the spirit of the women who survived the Middle Passage, withstood and overcame the oppression of enslavement,
we go forth heading north.
In the spirit of women who dared obstacles and challenged unjust barriers and forged new peoples in new lands, we go forth
heading south.
In the spirit of women who refused to be browbeaten and held back and opened new paths for others to follow,
we go forth heading east.
In the spirit of women who refused to be shut out and who demolished boundaries to open new spaces for sisters unborn,
we go forth heading west.
We go forth moving in all directions, moving at the directive of the Holy One, moving boldly and courageously in the assurance of divine guidance, anointing presence, and enabling power. In the spirit, not only of our ancestors in the sisterhood, but at the direction of Sister Wisdom, Sophia, who calls each and all to encourage her for the sake of God's glory.
We go forth. We go forth. Thanks be to God.
In Kigali, she wakes up, she looks.
she's half a world away. Something in me wants to say, we are one woman, you cry and I hear you. We are one woman, you hurt and I hurt too. We are one woman, your hopes are mine, and we shall. She reaches out, then teaches others how to. In Jaipur, she gives her name. She lives without shame. In Manila, Sultanbu.
Though we're different as can be,
we're connected. She with me.
Thank you, all of you, for joining us this evening. And for those on Facebook, thank you for joining us as well. We're so grateful for such a diverse and interesting and wonderful group of women who've joined us here this evening to do this service. So we hope to see you again at another service coming up very soon. Thank you.